This miner's in a tough spot, and he has only a few seconds to get out of it. It started here. As soon as he and his buddies got warning of an emergency, they dropped what they were doing and began to don their SCSRs. They knew the drill well enough to go through it in the dark, open the SCSR, put it on, pull the starter tag. But under pressure, this miner took a false step. He pulled the mouthpiece plug too soon. That left the mouthpiece open, so when he pulled the starter shot of oxygen that should have gone into his breathing bag escaped through the open mouthpiece instead. Ideally, he should grab another SCSR, but the nearest backup is too far away. So he must inflate the bag and start the SCSR with his own lung power. Luckily, he's practiced the manual start technique, and he knows just what to do. His job is to fill the breathing bag so he can start breathing safely and finish donning the SCSR. First, he grabs the nose clamp that's attached to the mouthpiece and clamps his nose shut. Then he takes his mouthpiece out, inhales a deep breath, puts the mouthpiece back in his mouth, and exhales into the SCSR. He does this anywhere from 3 to 6 times until his breathing bag is full. Then he keeps the mouthpiece in his mouth, finishes his donning steps, and moves out after his buddies, remembering to move and work slowly until his breathing bag stays inflated. But doing it right and fast takes practice. Let's watch. In donning your SCSR, you must take each step in the right order. The wrong step at the wrong time will spell trouble. When you open your SCSR, your mouthpiece is sealed with a plug. It's a safety device that keeps a starter shot of oxygen in your breathing bag until you need it. If you remove the plug before you pull the starter tag, your first breaths of oxygen will escape. That means that if no backup SCSR is handy, you'll have to fill the breathing bag and start the SCSR yourself with your own lung power. Here's how. First, grab the nose clamp that's attached to the mouthpiece and clamp your nose shut. Then, with the mouthpiece out of your mouth, inhale a deep breath. Put the mouthpiece back in your mouth and exhale into the mouthpiece. Blow hard enough to push air down into the breathing bag. Repeat the inhale and exhale cycle until the breathing bag is full. Depending on your size and lung capacity, it should take only 3 to 6 breaths. Then, keep the mouthpiece in your mouth, inside your lips and outside your teeth, so that no air can leak around it. Your breath will start the chemical reaction inside your SCSR that will give you all the oxygen you need. Now you can get ready to move out. Put on your goggles, adjust your neck and chest straps, put your hard hat back on, drop any excess gear, and head for an SCSR cache or the mine exit. Remember to move and work slowly until the breathing bag stays inflated.
It's important to prepare in every situation. I mean, we've got men working in this mine 24/7, sometimes, you know, 6 days a week, 3 shifts. Every miner here should know what they have to do to be safe in doing their job.
It's going to function either way, but there may be a chance that you need to use the manual startup. And if that's the case, we need to train our people to do that, prepare them for the worst.
In a pinch, the manual start technique can be your backup plan, but just like conventional starting, it takes careful practice. If you have any questions about manual starting or anything else about your SCSR, ask your trainer or supervisor, or check out the CSE SCSR manual. Remember that knowing how to use your SCSR can save your life the next time you're on the job.